Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit creatingcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and quote the item number on your screen.
Hey, welcome to Cake Academy. I'm Natasha McCarty. This hour, I'm joined by the fabulous Karen Davies. Now, the way, we'll have her in just a moment. Now, the way that Cake Academy works, if you've not watched it before, it's not really a sales show. We get to see all the demonstrations in full. This is all about inspiration for you. So you can record the whole series on Sky. You can set to series record, which is very handy, so you never need to miss a thing, and you can watch it then back as often as you like. Now, within the show, there are going to be products available for you to buy. They'll come up on a little L on the screen. It's a little L-shaped thing. There we go. That's your L there. After each demo, we'll just give you a run through, like a little shopping list of everything that's Karen's used. And so then if you want it, then you know exactly what we're getting. But obviously nothing's going to happen until we have the fabulous Karen. Karen, how
Hello.
Are you?
Hi. Great, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good.
Yes. Thoroughly enjoyed last Cake Academy with
oh,
you.
Oh, good. You've been busy making biscuits, I believe.
I did make biscuits.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
I have to say, though, the block of icing, you know, I ate that. That didn't get made
the whole block?
Yeah. Not in, like, one sitting.
Oh, good.
It was really tasty.
Oh, good. Good.
So just lots of lovely goodies on the show.
Yeah.
What are we making?
Yes. Well, today's theme is about rustic cakes and rustic moulds.
Okay.
We've got a new range. They've only been out a few weeks. And they're proving very popular because that's one of the cake trends at the moment. Rustic cakes.
Okay.
Lots of wood bark, basket weave. You know, the cakes you can see out on display are showing some of the things that I'll be doing today.
So it's all about the texture.
Yeah, yes, lots of texture.
Look at that basket weave there.
And I'll be explaining lots of things, what else you can do with them, and, you know, as I go along, showing you everything.
Excellent. So it's a full-on tutorial. I can't wait. Where do we even start?
Right. Well, I'm going to be using our sugar paste, as we said before, throughout. We've got marshmallow or vanilla flavours.
Now I can.
So you know,
I can say with all honesty.
Do you need to taste it again, or are you okay?
Yes, I will probably just to check that this. It's like quality control, Karen. I don't want to think that, you know, your standards slipped or anything. So it's important to check.
Okay, that's fine. They're the books that are available as well, but I'll move those out the way for now.
We'll look at those books in just a moment.
Apologies.
Now, it's important to say, isn't it, these moulds, you make and manufacture with your husband. This is all done.
We do. They're all designed and manufactured by ourselves. Our daughter Alice has designed this range. This one here is the
She's
wicker.
She's award-winning as well, isn't she,
yes,
your daughter?
Yeah, she won gold. Her first competition at Cake International, she won gold.
An extremely proud mother moment there.
Very. And when she said she was going to enter, I tried to put her off, to be honest, yeah. Because I was worried, you know, I thought, oh, you know, I think it's a big competition, isn't it, to enter? So I can't live it down now that she got gold.
No, and so now she's designing for you as well. So this is the...
Yeah, this is the wicker.
Okay,
so as with all the moulds, you put some corn flour in to prevent the paste from sticking, just a little bit. That's the Wilton dusting cup pouch, or it's in a handy little pot as well.
It is good,
so
isn't it?
I think you've got those available on your website. So this is some of our sugar paste, and I've coloured it with paste colour.
Okay,
to get the colour. I think Squires do a nice, I think it's called Teddy Bear Brown, that would work really well in this one. So I just need to soften it a little bit first and get it smooth before I start to roll it into the mould. Because this one, because it's quite a large mould, you'll notice the size of this range of moulds is the same size. I can't remember the exact measurement, but you can see how big it is compared to my hands. It's a good size mould, you know, value for money. We try and give as much as we can, you know.
Because normally you'd, when I've seen you work with the smaller moulds, you just, you sort of
you press them in. With this, I find it much easier to use a rolling pin. So what I do first is start to roll the paste out so it's almost the same width as the mould, okay, to go in.
Does it? Would you roll it so that it's slightly smaller or slightly bigger if you can't get it exact?
Slightly smaller is better. Okay, so I'm just going to turn that over and lay it onto the mould. And, sorry, I meant to say, you'll notice this end here is thinner and straighter than the other end. The opposite end
is
more...
isn't it? Yes.
Yeah, more jagged. And that's so they join together well. So I'll show you that when this comes out.
Okay, so... everything's been thought of. This is brilliant.
Yeah, you do. You have to think of everything before you... start to manufacture them. Yeah. You have to think how are the ends going to join together.
But you've been doing this for a few years, so you've got that experience.
Yes, quite
haven't you?
A few now. Yes. So I've just begun by pushing it into the corners and right up to that edge there. You see? Okay. So now, if it looks too wide, you can just pull it a little bit and stretch it.
It's quite malleable, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. It's a very, very easy paste to work with. All I do is start to roll it in. If it goes over the edge, just push it back in with your fingers. If it's going too wide, like before, you just pull it and stretch it slightly so it sort of sucks in before you roll again.
And what happens if it's not wide enough?
Right, if it's not wide enough, push it with your fingers to the edge. Okay. And you know you've rolled enough when you start to see sort of little lumps and bumps and shadows.
Yeah.
You know it's not going to go any thinner because the paste is level with this edge here, when you can see that. Okay. So we carry on rolling. You see how hard I'm pressing as well?
Yeah.
It's not going to stick. Okay.
Well, it's not going to stick. It's not going to break either,
no,
is it? Because it's,
no.
Is it a silicone mould?
Yes, it's silicone. It's tested food safe and they're very, very strong. Under normal use, it should last you forever. It should last you a lifetime.
Excellent.
Okay, so what I do is roll past the edge there. And then you can either take it off with your fingers or I've got a little knife here, a little palette knife, in the Wilton tool set. If you know that's as thin as it will go, you put that knife down flat and just push the paste off, you see, like that?
Yeah.
If you haven't got that, or you don't want to, you can just use your thumb to take the excess paste off there, okay? So that's ready
and
to
that's
come
it
out
done.
Now.
That was really quick.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so...
now, I'm going to have a suspicion, because I've used your moulds, that this is just going to flop out.
Well, you have to go and tell me. Remember, you turn it over, just hold the edges and just bend it back. There you are. See, it's out. Just bend it like that. That's it, quite quickly.
Done.
There's no need to put it in the freezer or anything, okay?
Just but that's because we're using your paste.
It's the right paste with
that's
the right type
the
of mould.
The right paste for the right job.
Yes. I was going to say, if you haven't got our sugar paste, I mean, it is available on your website, so it's easy, very easy to get hold of. But if you haven't got it or you run out and it's an emergency and you have to use something else, you can add CMC Tylo powder to your other paste to firm it up just enough to use. And the amount can vary depending on which paste it is that you're using, okay? Because they're all slightly different. Some sugar pastes can be softer than others, so, you know, you'd have to put a little bit more in.
But if you can, then get the proper paste.
Yeah,
And then you know that you're right paste, right mould, and then you're not... You're setting yourself up for success, aren't you, then?
Yeah.
Which is always a joy.
Yeah.
That is stunning. Look at that.
Now, you see the size. I think it's about 4 inches, if I remember correctly.
Yeah,
about 4 inches
looks
deep, which is a great size.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah, it's a great size for the side of a cake. I mean, you can see it on the top of this cake here.
Yeah.
We've trimmed it there. That's a bit smaller. So we've trimmed it a little bit, trimmed a little bit off to wrap it round that cake there, that top tier. The other thing you can do with them is use a former to make... you can make a basket, a hollow basket. It doesn't have to go round a cake. You know, you can trim it down. You could use something like a plastic Tupperware bowl or an empty margarine tub, you know, anything.
Yeah.
Just maybe grease it with a little bit of white vegetable fat like Trex or something. And then I would add Tylo to this so I know it's going to dry hard enough to set, sort of thing. So
excellent.
Now, joining them up, everybody always wants to know about joining the two together. So I've got one here I made earlier. Okay. So, right, that's the softer one, so we'll put it against this one here. Okay. So, what you would do, they would be on your cake, Okay, and you can see those edges sort of slot in.
Yeah, they do.
There's a little gap.
Oh, clever.
And it looks sort of rough on purpose because you want it to be disguised,
but
don't you?
But that's how it... That's, you can't really see the edge, can you? It's only because there's a slight colour difference.
Yeah, now, what I do now, when it's on the cake, that would be attached to your cake with water or edible glue. You then just get the Dresden tool. Again, this is out of the Wilton toolkit.
Mm.
And just use that to disguise the join like this. Okay.
Excellent.
And then it sort of disappears. You just keep doing it till till you're happy. Okay.
It's excellent, Karen.
Yeah, it's nearly gone. Okay. And so
perfect.
On.
Perfect. Completely camouflaged.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Okay.
So if you want the rustic wicker mould, then we're looking at £14 and 39 pence. There we go. 368269. Now, if you need, obviously, to get the sugar paste as well. Both delicious. Both delicious. There's marshmallow or there's vanilla. So you're getting a kilo there. It goes an awfully long way. £5 and 39 pence for that kilo. Sharon Davis sugar paste.
Karen.
Sorry. She's a swimmer, isn't she?
Yeah, I'm not a good swimmer.
Well, you know, but what you do is even better. So 363-645, Karen Davis.
Yes,
sorry.
Sharon probably can't decorate cakes.
Can't, yeah. Do you know, I didn't even notice that. 363-645 is your item number for that. And now the dusting cup that you used. Very handy to have. And again, this is just a one-off purchase, isn't it? Once you've got it, you've got it, and that's it, it's done.
Mm-hmm.
£6.29, 351152 is your item number there. And then the wicker mould. £15.99, be a member of the club and get it for £14.39, 368269. And then, of course, all the tools. Karen keeps saying about the tools that she's using, and this is the toolkit here. £32 and 39 pence, 351105 is your item number there. All part of our Cake Academy.
Okay, just quickly before I finish on the wicker, you can add some colour to it to add even more detail. I've just rubbed a little bit of brown powder colour into that brush there, and you can brush in down deep.
That goes on really well, doesn't it?
If you go into all like little crevices.
Yeah,
where it would naturally go up there. Yeah, I'll just do up this side here. So each time you always rub the powder into kitchen paper before you apply. Because once it's on, it won't come off.
Oh, right, okay.
So, you just want to build the colour up gradually on anything you do, anything like this. Anytime you use powder colours, just be careful you don't apply too much at once. So you can see there the difference. It's starting to look like the cake there on the top tier.
Yes, isn't it?
Yeah, you just brush that in.
This is all happening incredibly quickly, isn't it?
Yeah, of course, that's what they're for. Yeah, that's what they're for. You can spray over, you can get an edible glaze, which looks nice on there, this wicker one. Or I've just got a little bit of luster powder there, just to highlight the top of the basket. So I've just done under halfway.
Well,
there,
then
so
we've got a compare and contrast.
You can see the difference there with the two halves.
Isn't that, it just brings it to life, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Okay, so
$14.49 for that rustic wicker mould. Oh, you didn't just squidge that all up.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Well, that paste, well, our paste doesn't dry out very quickly either, so I'll be able to demonstrate with that again another time.
If I
just get it wrapped up, I'll be able to use it again.
Our director was saying, what? We could have eaten that.
Oh, dear. Well, we'll open these. We will open them, I promise. Right, this is the rustic cable knit. And it's got lots of different things on here that are very handy. The cake on the left there to the right on the screen. It's just a very simple cake, very quick and easy.
Just stunning. It's one of those things, isn't it, that there are lots of us that once we start crafting, we trip into other crafts.
Yes.
So you might be someone who knits, you know, and you might do a bit of baking. My nan, she was a big, big cake decorator and a knitter. They were her two things.
Yeah.
So that's the perfect cake for her.
Yeah, so that's it.
This is absolutely perfect. It looks so intricate, I wouldn't even know where to begin. But of course the moulds, it does the hard work for you, doesn't it?
Yes, exactly. So what we'll do, this one here, I'm going to make a sausage, roll a sausage of paste
how
to go into the mould.
How much do you know how to take? How much to take?
I don't.
Okay.
No, on most of the moulds, on the instruction sheet you get with the mould, it'll give you a weight for the piece of paste to put in.
And is that so by weight of your sugar paste?
Well, any sugar paste would be the same weight.
Right, okay.
But some of them, if it's something like, say, our brooch mould, and there's lots of different little brooches, I don't always put the amounts because it'd be too difficult to describe which one's which. But on anything sort of obvious, you know, we will give you the weights to put in. Okay, so do you want to have a go?
Yeah.
Okay, so you just see what I'm doing? I'm sort of pushing from side to side and down.
Sort of in like that?
Yeah, that's it. And it goes narrower there, so you know you've got to pinch it in and then push.
And then pinch in and push.
Yeah.
This is good. Oh, it is really therapeutic, isn't it?
It's nice. And the paste isn't sticky either, is it? It feels nice and firm
and
easy to use.
Isn't it?
No, so you've done really well. You've done really well. Usually I would have to say, now keep it level at the back. Don't go over the edges, but you've done all that.
Gold star.
You're a natural. That's it. So at the end there, I don't have to tell you anything.
I watched.
You watch, yeah. You've watched and learned, so it's easy, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. So that's fine. Now you just look along, make sure it's not over the edge anywhere, and it's ready to come out.
Are we taking it out now?
Yes. Yeah. So there's two ways with this one. You can either sort of turn it that way and just bend in half that way, or you can turn it over and bend from the end as before. Which do you think you'd prefer to do?
I think I'm going to go from there.
Yeah.
And then just pull it out quickly like that.
Yes.
And I say, a cable knit in any colour you like.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's excellent. And it does look knitted.
Yeah.
There was a gasp from the gallery upstairs. Ooh, look at that.
You want to watch it? They'll be giving you cake orders to do.
I know.
You have to stop pretending you can't do it.
Yeah.
if there is anything showing there, again, this Dresden tool, probably the most handy thing. Yeah, there's not. No, just if you can touch up any little bit you can see that you've missed. Okay, so that's how easy it is to do that one. Now, you've got lots of other little pieces here. You've got a little wooden toggle, isn't it? Yeah, toggle, like a little knitted knot, some hearts and a bobble
as well,
a little pom-pom bobble. I'll do this long, thin one, show you this one, because some people are a bit scared of anything that's long and thin, getting it out of a mould.
But yours, this just comes out so easily.
Yeah, yeah. The paste does work with other moulds as well. Was it a week or two ago, Katie Sue were on and they used it with theirs.
Yes.
So it does work.
No, actually, talking of Katie Sue, she does a lot with clay as well, with the air-dry clay. Can you use these with...
Yes. We've just started having a go doing all that.
But obviously, if you want to use it with your air-dry clay, have one for your sugar paste and one for your air-dry clay. Don't mix the two. It's not good.
Okay, so again, like this is a very long, thin one, so we just need to roll a thin sausage to put in. Now, anything, any of ours, if it's the pearls, a pearl strand or something, I always like this to be thinner than what it's being pressed into.
Okay.
Can you see there?
Yes.
So it's not going over the edges, because it'll just make it more difficult for you. I'll just push back into that top end.
Now, how did you get the colour for this?
Paste colours.
Okay.
Yeah, always paste colours.
So it's your paste and then you've just popped a colour in. And that doesn't affect the texture or the drying time
or anything like that? No, you can use this. You've got a lovely Squire's Kitchen set.
Yes.
Like a beginning set with every colour in.
It's a box, isn't it? It's beautiful.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, so that's perfect for anything like this.
We had that on a show a few weeks ago.
You did.
And I was oohing and aahing over that. It's really stunning.
So that's to the end. Just take it off with your thumb again. Okay. And that's ready to come out. This one, I'll bend this way. And hopefully... No, maybe not. Maybe I shouldn't. I can do it when I'm looking at it the other way round.
Yeah, you have to do it sort of looking into a camera screen. Now, you're not being particularly gentle with that either.
No.
No,
you don't have to be. It holds its shape really well.
And so you can put that around... Oh, look, you've done it again. Look.
Yeah, you can shape it.
And it just... Yeah. Look at that. That is a perfect... Perfect knitted circle. Oh, look, I like this. That's excellent. All you need to do is just
Yeah, it joins one end. Where's the join? I've lost it.
That's because you're so good, Karen.
Oh, there we go. That's it. Just pull it open, pull it apart.
Oh, you wanted to do stuff to it. Sorry,
I'm only going to brush the cornflour off. And I've got pink powder on my brush as well.
Okay, so a little bit of extra depth.
Yeah, it'll add... It just shows the detail better, doesn't it, if you have a bit of powder to it. You don't have to, of course, but it does look quite nice, I think.
This is lovely.
Okay. And the same with this one. I mean, this, I don't think, no, my pink isn't quite dark enough to show it
to
up,
do it,
maybe.
What,
but I'll give it a little go.
Like
I've got a Wilton, one of the Wilton paintbrushes out of the kit. The Wilton set, sorry, paintbrush set, not the tool kit. You've got two paintbrush sets, I think, haven't you, on the website. So there, I'm just brushing the pink in there where the two strands overlap each other and twist.
It just gives extra depth, doesn't it, and dimension.
Yeah.
But to be honest, even if you didn't have that, it'd still look great. Because
Well, on the white cake, because, there's nothing on there at all, and it still shows up really well. I just thought I'd do that just to show you that you can do all sorts to them.
Excellent. Truly excellent. Hey,
and just down the centre as well.
Just highlights it, doesn't it?
It just gives it more, makes a more 3D effect to it.
Oh, that's truly brilliant. Okay. So if you want the rustic table mould... Then it's coming in today at £15.29. Now, yes.
Is that everything? Course, yes, all the other bits.
You've got all sorts of other bits that come with it. So these are what you can be making. Oh, you can be making a cake like that. It's just amazing. Now, if you need the sugar paste, then it comes in marshmallow or vanilla. And it's £5.39. 363645 is your item number for those. Now, we've also got the dusting cup. So you pop that into your mould, which is cornflour, isn't it, they use, in with that. So £6.29, dust out your mould, and you're good to go. 351152. And then the decorative brushes. So we've seen Karen use those brushes. Oh, no, hang on. What have we got here? Oh, different picture. There we go. £8.99, 351155 is your item number for that. And it's all part of our Cake Academy. What are we doing next?
Right, next part. Tree bark.
Excellent.
Okay, the rustic tree bark. This is very, very useful because tree bark's very popular at the moment, like I said earlier. The cakes I've got out at the front here, the two with the tree bark on. Right, I'll explain about this one first with the birds on. We've used the wicker at the top, as you can see, just to give it a bit of light relief sort of thing, so it's not all tree bark all the way up. The birds just fit in really well, don't they, with it being a tree sort of thing, tree effect and everything. The flowers on the top are just handmade flowers, but you can use with the rose mould that you have on the website that I did on a show a few weeks ago. You can use that on this type of cake as well. So I'm going to show you how to do that bark. And the top of the cakes, anything with the tree, you need to make the top part of the tree, but that is very easy. You just use a paler sugar paste. Any of these moulds that I'm using the paste to wrap around the cake, you don't have to cover the sides of your cake with sugar paste. You can just sugar paste the top of your cake and then attach the moulded bark or the wicker or whatever with. If it's sponge cake, you'd use buttercream or jam. If it was marzipan, you'd just brush it with alcohol. So then your sugar paste isn't too thick.
Right.
You know, when you cut the cake, you haven't got two layers of sugar paste.
Yeah.
And the depth of these, it's a nice depth, a nice covering.
So it's not going to be too thick.
So it's not too thick.
And you've not wasted as well.
It's waste because it's too thick and you can't see it anyway. The top of the trees, you'll see that they're just marked, you know, with the... Here it is again, the Wilton Dresden tool kit.
It is a truly useful tool.
I do use
it
a lot, all the time. And all, Alice did this, not me, but all she's done is just marked some grooves randomly, not evenly. You just do them randomly.
Yeah.
And then some circles around the top and brushed with the powder colour onto that to get that sort of tree stump effect at the top.
Is this sort of an intermediate level are we looking at?
Beginners. I mean, you'll see now how easy it is to do.
Okay.
This cake here, what we've decided here, at the moment, this there's a lot of cakes called naked cakes. Around. It's not how it sounds.
Right.
I mean, basically, when you look at this cake, the top tier and the middle tier, that is how they look, apart from my lace that I've put on. Yeah. That is how they look before you put your sugar paste on. Okay,
right.
Isn't
okay.
it? So, the trend with these, cake decorators either love or hate them. There's right. mixed opinions about them. Because it's just buttercream like that, your sponge isn't protected by the covering of sugar paste.
Does that mean that it's going to go stale
yes,
more quickly?
Yes, exactly.
Right.
Exactly. It's going to go dry out quicker. Your sponge isn't going to last very long.
Does that mean that we should eat that today?
So,
just checking.
You've got to keep trying.
Well, I'll keep trying.
Yeah, so I decided, I call this my half-naked cake.
Okay.
Because we've done the bottom tier as a covered cake.
Okay,
so
that will
at
last
the wedding,
longer.
You know,
yeah.
if you're going to cut up the top two tiers, you've still got your covered cake at the bottom.
Do people
to
still
take...
keep that third tier?
Usually, it used to be the top tier for
was
a christening,
top tier? Yeah,
yeah,
that's
for
it.
A christening cake.
Yes,
I don't know. I'm not sure now how many people do because it used to be a fruit cake, and
yeah.
it's not as popular now as it was years ago. Everybody wants carrot cakes, lemon cakes,
yeah.
you know, so it's not as popular. But this bottom tier, of course, can be anything you want.
And
sponge, fruit,
longer, yeah.
anything. And you've got that to keep
and
after the
home.
Wedding. Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah. So I'll carry on now and do the wood bark. Okay. And, of course, with it being fresh buttercream on the cakes as well,
oh,
I'm not sure what the health
delicious.
And safety... Well, like, it does taste nice, but what the health and safety laws are about, you know, it going off quickly
okay.
and
okay.
things.
So,
you know,
you'd have to find that out, wouldn't you?
Yeah,
you
you've got to be
to do
yeah, quite careful. So I've got some brown here, brown sugar paste.
So are you going to have to roll this out again?
Yeah, again, the same
so
as
it's
before.
Like with the,
yeah.
With the
yeah, with
wicker.
The wicker.
That's the word I want.
Yeah,
wicker.
That's it. Okay. So bulrush is a good colour, squire's colour. I'm sure the dark brown is called bulrush. That would be
and
good
when
for
you
this.
Add in a colour,
mm-hmm.
how do you mix it?
Well, I just dip a cocktail stick into the pot of colour, put it into the paste and just knead it through. And the concentrated
so
colours...
That's a tiny amount.
Yeah. Yeah. For darker colours, you do add quite a bit more, but if you just go careful at first, that
yeah.
is too much, but, you know, I'll show you how to take it off at the end. So it's the same as before. Start to press it in to get into the corners.
Yeah. And is it to sort of setting it up with a good corner, does that stand you in good stead for
the join.
A nice... Okay.
Yeah, because if they were rounded, you're going to have trouble, aren't you?
Yeah.
They're going to have a sort of dip on each side. Okay, so that's ready again to roll in. So press really hard.
And you really are. There's no messing around with this. It's
no,
straight
and
in.
I just roll an inch or two at a time. It depends how much paste you've got to move along. Give a helping hand to. So we just push that along. And just roll at the end as well. Just a bit more, I think. Okay.
It's almost come off by itself, hasn't it?
Yeah. And then just trim off that end there. Same as before with the knife or with your thumb.
And so that's out of the toolkit, isn't it?
Yes, it is. The Wilton toolkit, little palette knife. Very handy. Okay, so now, again, that's ready to come out. It's into the corners, not going over the edge. So just turn it over and peel
back.
That away.
Excellent.
So you're off to a great start because you've got all the detail there that you need. So
and actually, I quite like having a little bit of that corn powder on there.
The corn flour.
Corn flour
yes.
powder on there because it's already giving it some texture,
yeah,
isn't
that,
it?
That will go now anyway because I'm going to brush it in. I might actually put it on a piece of kitchen paper because there'll be brown powder everywhere.
Right.
So.
And again, you're not delicate with this. You're not worried about it coming
can
out
see
of shape
that better
or anything
as well
like that.
Than against the similar coloured worktop. So we've got this is chocolate brown colour.
No, so you do always tap off.
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to use quite a lot with this. It's not so important really because you're going to use quite a lot to colour it.
Okay.
So I'll just start to brush it in.
So you're going more for getting your colour with powders rather than going for a darker colour with the actual paste itself?
Yeah, yeah, because the powder, you see, naturally, it just catches it
yeah.
and some areas look lighter than the others. But we're going to deepen it further. I'm going to leave a little piece at the end, not coloured. I'll just brush away the cornflour a little bit there so you can see it better. So that's your sort of base colour.
I'm thinking Yule logs and things
yes.
like that. Isn't it? It's perfect for Christmas time.
I'm really looking forward to doing some Christmas cakes with this one, especially.
Yeah.
Because when you think about it, you know, the bottom tier, or, you know, one of these cakes, instead of having to do the top, marking it, like I said before, you can put your snow over the top, you know, hanging over a little bit, snow around the board.
Oh,
the lovebirds done as robins by the log, and whatever,
perfect.
Some holly, and yeah, so it's
just
a good
perfect.
It's a good Christmas one to have. Okay, so you see, that's sort of brought out the detail
yes.
there. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'll swap that for a darker brown.
Oh.
Okay, this one, I can't see what that's called. Oh, can't see the name. Sometimes I have my powders. You can see this is nearly empty, so I've had this one a while.
Time,
and
I think
the name has worn off.
It's a miniature.
So you see there, I've gone in the deeper parts where the bark is actually a little bit deeper. You can brush that darker colour right into those little grooves in places.
Oh, it looks delicious.
Okay.
In a really woody way.
It would be really good for any chocolate paste as well. You could do it with you know, the Squire's Kitchen do really good chocolate paste covering. So okay, so that's
excellent.
That's good enough, really. I think Alice said she also sometimes she adds a little touch of black.
Could you also go with a little bit of green so that
yes.
you know, so that
do you know, I meant to put green powder in because it you can make it look like as though there's moss.
Yes.
A little bit of moss on it. Yeah, you are good at this. I think you've done it before somewhere.
No, well, do you know what? It's not this that I've done.
The crafts.
I used to be a scenic artist, and we had to do a massive party for it. Was when Lord of the Rings came out, and we did their after show party.
Yeah.
And we had to do these 20-foot high trees.
Oh, wow.
Tree bases.
Yeah.
But it was all sprayed. It wasn't done like this.
You needed this.
But it was trying to get, and it was trying to get the colours, and I'm transported right back there thinking, what colours did we use? And we used greens and all sorts of things.
Yeah, I think it was only yesterday evening. I think I saw something on TV and there was a tree, because you when you do cakes or crafts or whatever, you're always looking around at everything.
Yeah,
and I thought, moss, I haven't done any green, you know, one.
And the toadstools and things as well. You
oh,
know
yes.
They come out
sort of like
that.
Yeah, round the bottom.
In yellows and things like that.
Yeah,
Look amazing.
Yeah, yeah. So there you go. You can still add a little highlight to it if you want to, with a little bit of white or luster. Especially at Christmas, you'd probably...
Of course.
Oh, that's too much, far too much.
But not that much.
Yeah, it's too much. But just a little bit. All the varnish, the spray, the clear spray varnish. I'm going to go over that with some brown. Tone it down a little bit.
Well, that is fabulous.
Okay, so you
look
see
that.
Okay.
Excellent.
So
if you want to get the rustic bark mould, it is £14.39, 368265. Just brilliant. And, of course, made again with Karen Davies. Probably because Sharon Davies. You see,
don't
I was
worry.
A child when she was swimming.
Yeah.
She was one of my heroes. the rustic bark mould, and then, of course, the cake paste as well, which will come for coming up for just a moment. That's £5.39, 363645 is your item number for that. Utterly delicious, marshmallow or vanilla, really, really delicious. Now, we're doing some lovebirds.
Yes, the lovebirds, okay. I'll show you these first, these birds, that's it.
Just wait till you see these.
Right, there's a lot you can do with this mould, okay.
Isn't it? Is that all the same mould?
Yes, they're all the same. Yeah, so there we've got the blue tits, doves and lovebirds there.
Gorgeous.
So it depends how you colour them. They're just a plain, simple bird shape. So you can adapt them.
Rather an artist, aren't you?
Well, not me, Alice did this.
Oh, this is Alice again. Well done, Alice. She's rather an artist, your daughter, isn't she?
Yeah. Yes, so I'm going to make some birds now.
Okay.
And there's a nice space here to put some robins.
Yay!
So
course.
I know it's not Christmas, but they're all
You're
made exactly
robins.
The same way.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's great when you buy things, you know, that you can use for different occasions.
Do you know, I hadn't spotted that they were all the same. I thought you had three different moulds.
No. Right. I'll just do one.
But that's
one
brilliant
bird.
Because it really shows how diverse it is, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, okay, so I've cornflowered it as usual, and don't know where I've put my light paste that I had. I did colour some lighter. That's it there. That's it. I took it out the bag to get to the tree and then forgot. So just knead that up to get it softer and smooth. You see, that's been out of the bag, not covered, but it's still okay
it
to
is,
use.
Isn't it?
It just
yeah.
needed back to usable paste. So I've made a teardrop sort of shape that I'm going to push and flatten into the mould.
Okay.
I don't worry about the beak and the feet at first.
Right.
If you find you're sticky, hot and sticky, just put a little bit of cornflour onto your fingers because you've seen how easy they come out.
Yeah.
So if your fingers are sticky, they will lift out very easily. Okay, so just take the excess off. So now I'm going to push it into the beak and the feet. So you don't just push like this. If you pinch between your fingers like that, you see it sort of pushes the paste up. And then there's enough there to push down into the beak. And then what I do is gently stroke it back, not too quickly like that, okay?
Okay.
And then the same into the feet, between two fingers and into the little feet there.
And get his little toes in.
Yeah, okay. So it's right up to the edge and not going over the edge. So that's ready to come out now. So we just turn it over.
Oh, and there he is, absolutely perfect. Feathers,
I'll put him onto a piece of white paper.
He's just superb.
So we can see him better there. Okay.
Gorgeous.
It's easier to see. Okay, so...
So he could be any bird right now.
Yes. Yeah.
But he's about to be transformed.
Yes, into a robin.
Into a robin.
So first of all, I'm going to use some brown on him, around the outside edge.
So these are with the Wilton brushes again, aren't they?
Yes. Oh, that one isn't, because I haven't got quite enough there with me. So this one is just one I've bought in an art shop. So we'll just brush that up from the tail. When you're putting colour on anything, I always try and go the outside edge in.
Okay.
So if it's darker, it always looks better darker.
Yes.
And it softens in towards the centre.
Well, it gives you a shading, doesn't it? So it gives that extra three-dimensional
effect. So I'm actually now going to go from the top of the beak over the top of his head, like that. Okay, so you can see there the shading on him.
Beautiful.
Okay.
How easy was that and how quick? And all that detail and that beautiful mould. Every
now
feather,
I've got some
everything.
Red. So blot that on the paper and then brush him. I'm going to go from here down. This is very red, a bright red. A nice deep orangey red works well for robins. So go
just
up onto his sort of cheeks there and down.
Bit of blush.
Yes, a blush. I'm doing this very, very quickly. Alice will probably tell me I've done it wrong.
What? No, I mean, because it looks stunning. How can that be wrong when it looks so good?
And then I want a little bit of white.
Otherwise Alice can come and do it.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I'm trying to talk her into it.
She's going to criticise. Come and do it yourself live on TV and see how easy it is. I take my hat off to you demonstrating live on
it's
TV.
It's gone a little bit pinky there because I haven't got quite enough brushes. So now I'm going to paint his eye. So I want a very small brush. I'm just using alcohol because it dries quickly and it paints really well.
Now you put that straight into the lid, don't you? Because it does just evaporate and then it's gone.
Yes, yeah, because that powder colour in the lid I can reuse again and again. But there's nothing wrong, you can use a paint palette. So we're just painting his eye there.
Isn't that gorgeous? Oh, look at him.
And that will dry almost instantly. Okay.
Now, how easy would this be to mount this onto your cake?
You need to let it dry, really. Let it set.
And how long is that going to take?
A couple of hours. But if you do want it to dry hard, it's always better to add some Tylo CMC to it.
Okay.
Just give it a bit of extra strength. If it's something you want to stand up on the side of a cake, that is better. I try not to use that if I can, because it does make things dry out very hard and brittle, so
then it can't be eaten.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so I've just mixed a little tiny bit of white, and hopefully, just paint a tiny dot. I'm always scared when I do that. It's going to run, but it didn't. Just a tiny little dot of white into the eye.
Just gives that highlight, doesn't it?
Yeah, that brings it to life.
Oh, that's perfect.
So what's next is feet on his beak. So
yes.
Now, I should have brought some, like a yellowy gold colour with me, but I haven't got it. So I'm just going to mix a little bit of silver, which would be okay. So if I just paint over his little feet there.
Aww.
They look slightly dark, so I could go over it with some white luster. And then his beak. Now the beak, that's another thing you can do with them, is cut open the beak so it looks like he's singing.
Oh yes, because they've got such lovely songs, robins.
So just carefully snip there. And you've got to do that while the paste is still soft. Mm-hmm. So you see now he's singing.
Oh, he is. Oh, he's just wonderful.
And then just paint the beak. So we'll just brush that on.
I find it quite mesmerising,
I have
to say.
There we go, like that.
Brilliant.
Okay, so now I can show you a cake with stuff. I know it's not Christmas, but I couldn't resist.
Oh, have you done one you made earlier? Oh, yeah. Look!
It just shows you another something you
that.
Can do
just
with them.
I couldn't resist.
Okay, and they've just got little Christmas hats added as well.
That's excellent.
This
That's
was done before excellent. We had our bark mould. So of course, your robin sat on the log.
But
made
now
with the bark
could sit mold. On that beautiful bark mould that you've got. Perfect. So if you want to get the lovebird moulds, and they're just charming, £14.39. But of course, don't just think lovebirds, think all birds. This is a bird for all occasion. 368273 is your item number for those birds. Now, of course, don't forget your sugar paste, because that's just going to be the right tool for the job. It's absolutely perfect for this type of work and tastes delicious. £5.39 for a kilo of it, 363645. And then, of course, the dusting cut, which Karen always uses. Don't start using that mould without it. £6.29, 351152. And, of course, then we've got the brush sets as well, the Wilton brush sets. And that's £8.99 for those, 351155. Perfect. All part of our Cake Academy. Ooh, what have we got
right,
next?
The final rustic mould is the basket weave mould. Okay.
Lovely.
And like I said before, with the wicker, you could do this around a former or a Tupperware pot or something to make an actual basket.
Yes.
It's not just for the sides of your cake or whatever.
Look at it on that cake.
Or you can cut out circles for cupcake tops, lots of different things. So, yeah, on the cake here, I'm going to show you the Lottie lace that's on that cake as well. Because it just gives it a nice finish.
Layers, you've used some of the knit, that long, thin
that's
part
it,
of
that,
the knit,
yes,
haven't you?
Yes, this one here.
That
off
one.
The, yes, off the cable knit.
So that one has done round the border. This is a really handy one, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Excellent, yeah. Okay.
It's a nice, nice finish, that one, because it's good for a basket edge. All baskets have a little woven edge to them, don't they?
Of course they do, yeah.
Okay, so like before, again, the corn flour into the mould.
So you tap it in, then
tap it out. Okay, and then, I don't think which piece I was kneading then, so that one. So knead that, get it smooth, doesn't take long. Normally when I'm demonstrating, the paste has been in the car or the van and it's really cold to work with, but in here it's ready. Very quickly.
Oh, it's under the lights, isn't it? It's warmer.
Yeah, it's great. So, okay, we'll just get the width first and then start to roll it into the shape to make it easy.
Okay.
So pop that in. You always turn them over because you can see there the cracks. You don't just lift it across. Turn it over and then start to push it into this edge so you can see that...
Oh, this is going to be a connector edge again. It's all thought out perfectly,
yeah, turn it
isn't
this
it?
Way, make it a bit quicker. And easier to do. Okay. So, I mean, basket cakes are quite useful for lots of different things, aren't they? There's so many baskets for novelty cakes as well. Things like baby baskets,
of
you know,
course.
With all the baby equipment and toys.
Teddy bears, picnics,
yeah,
things
all
like
sorts.
That.
It's fishing baskets, anything.
Oh,
lots
yes,
of different flower baskets, you know, the list.
Well, that's just it, isn't it? It's a great excuse for
the
your
list
flowers,
is endless.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so I've started it off there, okay.
Okay.
And just pulled it along and then start to roll.
And again, you can start to see, can't you, the lumps
yeah,
and the bumps
exactly.
coming
yeah.
through, so you know that you're at the
yeah,
right
you
depth.
Yeah, you can see that pattern. I just stretch that a little bit and roll again. As soon as you see it going over the edge, push it in and just stretch it. It's far too much there, isn't there?
That's and okay, then you can never have too much.
Push that along. And then the Wilton knife again, your little palette knife.
But actually, that just goes to show, doesn't it, mm-hmm. when you say, oh, I didn't think that was going to be too much when you put it in there.
Yeah.
But it just shows how cost-effective this is going to be, because you're not wasting tons and tons and tons of icing,
no,
are you?
No, no, like we said before, you know, you just ice the top of your cake, and then this goes around the sides.
Excellent.
Okay, so that's ready to come out now. So just make sure it's right up to the edge and not going over the edge. Mm-hmm. And then again, just turn over, bend the end back.
Perfect.
Peel away.
Perfect every time. Okay. I don't know why I even sound surprised, Karen, now. You know, this is my second show with you and there hasn't been a duff one yet. Every single one has come out
give
perfectly.
Me a chance.
Well, not to tempt fate
know.
Or anything. But that's why the moulds are so good, isn't it? Because they are, I know that I was talking to your husband about moulds in the green room.
Yeah.
And just the amount of research he did to get these just right.
Yeah, yeah. We wanted, we wanted them to work. We wanted them to be food, you know, tested safe for food, to be good silicon that, you know, in 2 years' time we weren't going to get complaints that they'd fallen apart or like moulds I had years ago used to break and things. So these won't do anything.
They're sturdy,
they are very,
yeah.
very. Okay, so I'll put that to one side for now.
So as a beginner. I could do this. This is easy to do.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
But I'm not going to look like a beginner, am
yeah,
I, at
no.
all? Excellent.
No, no. Right, I'm not going to mould another piece to slot into this one. I'll just cut this one in half and show you how they join up. Okay, so
the other end
cut that down the centre. Yeah. I mean, obviously, this would have water or edible glue or buttercream behind it, so it wouldn't slip about probably as much as this is going to do. But you see, they slot into place. But because it moves, it's not. If it was a solid piece, it'd be easier, wouldn't it? Because they've moved and stretched about a little bit. You need to give them a little bit of a hand.
But I have to say, I mean, that's gone in pretty well, just as it is, isn't it?
Yeah, really? But what you can do, like that corner there is sticking up. So you just use your Dresden tool to push that in.
That Dresden?
Again.
Again?
Have I used it with everything? I think I have.
So is that your go-to tool?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, there's not much more to do there, really.
The,
if you push them as tightly as you can when they're on the cake, the join will be a lot less visible.
That's
okay, and then any that are, you just use the Dresden tool to tease it into place and push it into place. Okay.
That's perfect. That's so clever.
And
so,
then,
so clever.
Like before, if you wanted to, you could add depth to it by dusting with your colours, with your powder colours. So I've got some pink here. So you would go into that edge there like that. There's hardly any.
Then
the other way, the other direction.
Of course, my mind's going 19 to the dozen, thinking of all the things that I can put
you
in a basket
do.
Right now. Kittens, puppies.
Oh, yes.
They're all coming out of baskets in my head.
Oh. Yeah, so a flat dusting brush. Again, this is from the Wilton set.
Mm-hmm.
You just put that edge... Tuck it.
Slots in nicely,
yeah,
isn't
you
it?
Just tuck it deep, you know, where the weave goes underneath, like that. So you get the shading and so on. It takes a while to do it all, but I don't think it needs it personally. But if you want to, you can. So, you know, it's up to you.
The mould itself is so detailed.
Yeah.
You've just got to follow where's darker on the mould, haven't you? And just emphasise that. That's
yeah.
all you need to do. So if you're in any doubt, just follow that.
Yeah, yeah. And then I would go over it. When I've done that dusting, I would go over it with the lustre. It just softens the colour and blends it in.
So it works like a blender then?
Yeah, it just, and then highlights the lighter parts.
Beautiful.
Whatever. So, you know, it's up to you as how much you do, as little or as much as you want to. Okay. So, the finishing touch with this one is the Lottie Lace, which I've used on the cake there. So, if I show you this one, this is a very, very popular mould.
Okay.
Because you can do quite a lot with it. Now, most of the moulds, I use cornflour.
Yes.
But
I'm feeling a but coming on.
I mean, on the cake at the end with the basket weave there, I've kept it plain. I've used the cornflour with that one.
Okay.
But quite a lot of times with this Lottie lace, I use luster in it.
Right.
And it just, it releases the paste from the mould, but it gives the paste a really good shine. Because with luster colours, normally you brush them on afterwards. But
right.
Because this is in the mould and you're pressing your paste into the mould, you're pressing the luster into the paste.
Okay.
So you get
into
a really...
all the nooks and crannies.
Yeah, so you get a really good shine on it. So just start off at the end there, pressing into the corners and just work it in with my fingers. Most of these moulds, when they're long and thin, I'm going from side to side and down, and it does it much quicker.
Yeah.
If you push down like that and flatten it, it spreads the paste sideways. You don't want that. So it's always like a rocking motion, side to side and down, and then take
so
it off
quick.
At the end. It is quick. You want them to be quick. Okay, and that now, you want that to come out straight away.
Yes.
You know, you don't want to be leaving it for a little while to firm up or anything, or putting it in the freezer. You want them to come out straight away. So you bend the end back and bend the mould away. Now, what you do now is take your luster brush again and polish it. You don't
need... So you can sort of buff it?
Yeah. You don't need to put any extra powder on. What's there just gets sort of polished up like that.
Amazing.
Okay. So that's the lace just as it is. Plain, and that has been attached to this cake here. I've done it the same colour as the buttercream on the cake, just plain.
Yeah.
But I've actually cut out little...
Let me hold that up so you can really see.
Cut out some little holes in the lace as well.
Look at the luster on there. Isn't that gorgeous?
So it's up to you now. You can leave it as it is, or you can cut some holes with a piping nozzle.
It just looks exquisite. It looks like our metallic papers die cut, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's amazing.
So I was watching that before, yeah. Yeah, it does. So, you know, you can cut out holes. So let's see what size. I think that's a three or four, that one. So it's quite a big nozzle. But if you want it to look more lacy, you can cut little holes along the lace like that.
So you're just going in where there's already a slight
see,
hole.
Yes, there is, isn't there? A little mark there, so you know exactly where to cut. I don't always do this, you know, it depends what effect you want.
Oh, gosh.
And you can see again how easy it is to handle, like all the others. So the other thing you can do now is stretch it. So what you do is you put a finger either side and then just do that.
Okay.
I'll turn it round in a second, so...
Amazing.
So you get that nice wavy edge.
So you've got a scallop, a laced scallop.
Yeah, the other thing you can do, you can bend the lace as well, so you can get a curved piece.
Karen, this is amazing.
Okay.
This is all top tips, top tips.
Okay, so I've got a board here that I've made earlier to show you some other things you can do with it.
Just incredible.
So you can layer it in different colours.
Oh, look at that. Oh, baby showers.
So we've gone from the darker pink,
pale
pink to white there. And you just keep it straight, do the stretched edges and keep it straight. And then that's the same as I've done there with the curve on. And I've just used bows from our bow mould.
Beautiful.
Okay. And then here, the bottom one, that gives a lovely side design using... our Elizabeth lace as well, which is on your website.
So that's through the middle and then that one
either side.
Gorgeous.
Yeah. And the bows are on your website
Clever thing. So do take a look at the website, www.createandcraft.tv, if you're after any more of Karen's moulds. They're all on there. And of course, it's all under Cake Academy on there as well. So if you want recipes and ideas, then Cake Academy is on there for you. Various videos and all sorts. So do take a little look around there. So let's just have a little recap of everything that Karen's just used. So let's start with the basket weave. Oh no, that's the Lottie lace mould. Oh no, that's going. Oh, the basket one's coming up now. Here we go. So your basket weave mould there, £14.39, 368270 is your item number for that. And then the Lottie lace, which is just beautiful. Again, £13.49, 368285. How versatile is that mould? Just brilliant. And then your sugar paste. This is a must-have. If you're using these moulds, I'm sorry, this is an absolute must-have. £5.39, 363645. When someone like Karen, with her experience, makes her own sugar paste, She's done it for a reason. It's because you couldn't find it anywhere else. So that's a great one to go. Now you've got your dust and store dusting cup there, £6.29, 351 152. And of course, don't forget your tool set as well that you've seen Karen using. £35.99 for all of that, or £32.39 if you're part of the club. 351105 is your item number for that. And then your decorating brushes, which are coming up. There we go, £8.99 for those, 351155. And then, oh no, big one there. This is your two-piece dusting brush, £8.99, 351260. All part of Kate Academy, of course. Now, what are we doing
okay,
now?
Well, I'll let you taste it.
Oh, thanks. Because, I might have forgotten.
Yeah.
Oh,
see what you think it tastes of.
Which one's this?
This is the marshmallow.
Oh, I do like the marshmallow.
Can tell.
I'm going straight in. Oh, there's no messing around. Producer Jacob keeps telling me we've got emails on the tablet. I know we've got emails, but I've got sugar paste. Sorry. Sugar paste trumps emails. What are we doing with this?
Right, I was just going to do one more Lottie Lace and show you how to join it together.
Okay, we've got a minute.
Begins. 1 minute.
Can we do it in a minute?
Right. Right. Well, it is quick to do, isn't it?
Mm, absolutely is. You do that. I'm
okay.
Going to find an email and finish off eating the icing.
Okay.
Now, we've got a picture. Have we got time to show the picture? This is a cake I made. This is from Pearl with Karen's Moulds. I bought the book last time she was on. They are so easy and brilliant to use. Of course, all the books on the show. Look at this.
Oh,
stunning.
Gorgeous. Oh, the carousel. That's lovely.
Absolutely stunning. And Lorraine says, I love all the new moulds from Karen. Here's what I did with them for Easter. Oh. Wow. Brilliant.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Oh, crikey, lots. Look at that. Brilliant. We are running out of time.
Busy.
We've got 15 seconds
left.
No.
Oh, no, no, no. Well, basically, all you do, right, that's, I'm not finishing it off very well at the end there. The two ends.
We're done. We're out of
sorry.
Time.
Well, use a piping nozzle.
Cake Busters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit creatingcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and